Good morning, everyone.
You're very welcome back to Age and Opportunities Movement Minutes with myself, Paul. We're back at the end of another week. Today's Friday, of course, and today, as normal, is going to be our seated or standing session, whichever you prefer. So we'll be demonstrating exercises for both. Whether you want to do the session seated, standing, or a mixture of both, we'll have exercises to demonstrate how you can do that. So we have people joining in there already. Jerry, Phyllis, good morning, how are you? Good to see you both. I know we had a great gang in here on Wednesday for the standing session. We had people from Leash, Athlone, Cavan, Cork, and we had Joan McCormick as well from London. So it was great to have you all here. Let us know where you're tuning in from today. We'll give it another few minutes just for people to get tuned in. I know I'm always a wee bit lax on a Friday as well, so I'll just give people another few seconds just to tune in with us here this morning. All you're going to need this morning, folks, is just your own body weight. If you're doing it standing, you're not going to need any equipment or anything fancy. And if you plan on doing it seated, you'll just need your sturdy chair as well, okay? And if you feel it's not that sturdy, just have it up against a good sturdy surface such as a closed door or a wall as well. We have a few more joining in there. We have Carol from Ballantyre. Good morning, Carol. Good morning, Kathleen. Helen, how are you? Great to have you here. They're starting to come in now. They're always a wee bit slow on a Friday night like myself. We have Mark and Anne Howard there. Martina, Paula. Great stuff, folks. Paula and Paddy. Better not leave out Paddy. Paddy, we might need you at the end. They're down in Kilkenny there, so stay tuned with us, Paddy. We might need your help at the end now. Or Paula might need your help. Slowly but surely we're coming in there. So what we might do, folks, we'll get started, I think. And again, as always, this can be watched back on YouTube or it can be watched back on this page as well. So, okay, so if you're watching it back, you're very welcome and it's great to have you here. I'm going to ask my trusty assistant now to join us. Again, she's like the rest of us, maybe a bit slow getting up on a Friday. So Siobhan's going to demonstrate the standing exercises today and I'm going to take it easy. I've had a tough week. I'm going to take a nice seat and relax and demonstrate the seated exercises. With Marie Byrne there from Dublin as well. You're very welcome, Marie. So before we begin, I'll just ask everybody now, just choose if you're going to sit or stand, and you can take your position. I'll get you to take both your hands in, just take it to the centre of your chest. You're going to close the eyes, and you're going to inhale in through your nose, and you're going to lift your arms up at the same time, okay? Or your elbows up to the side. So we're going to inhale in through the nose, and go out for an exhale. Great stuff. In through the nose again. And exhale. And one last time. In through the nose. And exhale out. Just place the hands on your lap then. In the front of your thighs. And slowly open your eyes. And what I'll ask you to do now is just lift up your shoulders. Both either side. And you're just going to roll back and down. Okay, up again, back and down, and last time now we're going to take it extra slow, so slow on the way up, and then a slow roll back, and that's where I want you to keep your shoulders now throughout the session if you can, okay? So that'll just help our posture stay nice and tall, so just shoulders back and relax as well. So we have a few more in there, so we'll get going. We'll start off with our warm-up, and again, just let me know about the music and my voice as well. If it's too loud or too low, just let me know. So we're just going to start off, just tapping the feet. Just sticking the fingers. Okay, we're going to keep tapping the feet. We're going to do the hands now, we're going to throw it out. Take it back, out, and back, that's it. Taking the elbows in as well. Great stuff. Posture nice and tall, whether you're seated or standing, just sit up nice and tall and just roll around. That's it. From then, we're just going to reach high above the head, take it back down to shoulder height, high above the head and down, or as high as you can go. Okay, if you feel if you can't get up above your head, you can come out in front. But if you can manage, just reach it up as high as you can. And back down. That's three. Two. And last one, we're going to bring our hands in by our side then. Just bring them up the shoulder height, no higher. And back down, or up as high as you can. And down, all the way up. And down, great stuff. We're going to go for three more. Last two. And last one, great stuff. From there, we're going to cross the arms in front, and we're going to turn to our right hand side. We're going to hold for one, two. Come back to centre, out to the left. Hold for one, two, and back to centre, out to the right, back to centre again, and one more time out to the left, and back to the centre. From there now we're going to move on to the hips, and what we're going to do, we're just going to lift the knee up in front, so we're just working the hip joints, so just one at a time, so we're going off the right first, and the left, and again, your stand makes you on, and you feel if you need an extra bit of balance, just grab either a chair or a hard surface. Alright, a good sturdy surface. That's three, two, and last one. We're going to lift the heel off the ground now, and we're just going to tap out to the side for three, and tap back in for three, off the right again for three, and in for three, and one more time off the right out, and back in. We're going off the left foot now, lift up that heel, and tap the toe one, two, three out to the side, and one, two, three back in, out for three. In for three, and last time now out for three, and back in for three. The right heel out in front, then your right toe behind. Heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe, heel, toe. Back to the heel. We're going to stop it there. We're going to go to the left foot now. So heel, toe, heel, and so if you're like me and you're seated, you're just taking that heel back onto the chair. That's four, three, two, and one. And from there, we're just going to lift the heel slightly off the ground. If you're standing, you're just going to do this one at a time. I'm going to do both. So you're just going to swish from side to side. Over and back, like so. And then if you're standing, you're going to change to the other foot. Anybody sitting, it's just going to keep going. And that's it. That's four, three, two, and one. And then you're going to put the heels on the ground now, and you're going to swish the toes. Again, if you're standing, just one foot at a time. If you're seated, you're going to. Just over and back. That's it. And then you're going to change your left foot if you're standing. That's three, two, and last one. And from there, I'm just going to get into a march. So we're moved on now for a warm-up, okay? So the next few exercises, we're just going to try and target the whole body, okay? So we're going to get the heart rate up, and we're going to get the muscles working as well. And get the lungs just pumping air in the body as well. Alright. So from there, what we're going to do now, we're just going to stop, have our feet flat, and again, you can do this seated or standing. So what I'm going to ask you to do, if you're seated, just sit to the front of your chair, and you're going to lift your right knee up. You're going to clap under your right thigh like so, okay? And then the left, and you can do the same standing, the right, and left. I feel very precarious here now, but too close for comfort. So nice and steady, just go at your own pace, okay? So, like I said, on Wednesday, you can stay in the slow lane like myself, just take it nice and easy. Or if you fancy a bit of a challenge, you can pick up the speed like you want. Over and back. And what we're going to do now, we're going to come onto the right leg, and then we're going to tap up with the right, and come onto the left leg, and tap with the left. So right, left, up, right low, right high, left low, left high. So just over and back. Reach it up. As you can see, we're getting the arms and legs, the whole body moving here now as well. Off each, and up, left, and up. And from there, we're just going back to our march. We're just marching on the spot. We'll just get our breath again. And again, if you need to step out at any stage, feel free to do so. Do as much as you can for as long as you can. That's what I always say. Okay, you don't have to do exactly everything we're doing. So we'll try that again. So we're just going to start low onto the right, and then onto the left. right, left, left, that's it. And then we're going to take in the arms now, so we're going right to low, right to tight, left low, left tight. Right low, right tight, left low, left tight. Great stuff. All the way up. And down. The neighbours will have to watch along. I think they're getting around with applause. And last one on the right. And last one on the left. And up high. We're just going to march the spot. Now we're going to march the spot. Now we're just going to do the pom-poms. So these cheerleaders. I know there was a few here last week. And these cheerleaders. Now we're just going to move the pom-poms in front. Okay, we're going to turn to our right. Keep the hands going. Back to centre. And out to the left. Keep them going. Back to centre again. And now we're going to go in reverse. To the right. Back to centre. To the left. And back to centre. Change direction again. We'll go for 10 fast. Away we go. As quick as you can go. Or as quick as you feel comfortable. Keep the feet moving as well. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And slow it down now in reverse. Just going backwards. And 10 fast in reverse. Away we go. Keep the feet moving as well if you can. If you find that too much, just tap them one at a time. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great stuff, okay? Just take the hands by the side now. You might feel them a bit tender. So a good bit of work there. So just relax them out again. Just march it on the spot. And what we're going to do now, right foot first, we're just going to kick out, tap out in front and back in. Tap with the left and in. And we're just alternating now right and left. Over and back. That's it. Just tapping that toe out in front. And what we're going to do now, we're going to try and raise it a small bit, if you can manage. And we're just going to hold it there. And we're going to walk the right foot again and we're just going to kick out in front. Okay? So out. Just one leg at a time. And again, if you're standing with your ball, if you need that extra bit of support, by all means, just hold on to the door. Or hold on to a chair, just whatever's beside you, and which you feel will be sturdy. And again, just keep that posture nice and tall. Okay. From there, we're going to add in the arms now, so left arm, right arm, we're doing one at a time now. So we're just reaching out in front, all the way out, that's it. And again, if you feel that's too much, just take the arms out of it. Then you can just do the legs or vice versa, take the legs out and do the arms, you can build it up gradually. And what we're going to do now, we're going to add in, so it's going to be opposite, so we're going to go opposite arm, opposite leg, away we go, so right leg, left arm. Kick and reach. Out in front. That's it. Great stuff. All the way out. Do it to the beat if you can. If you keep that pace. And again, if you want to go on the slow lane, by all means. If you want to pick it up, then jump on the fast lane. That's 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Great stuff. Again, just shake out the legs if you need. Shake out the feet, the arms. The hands, how are we doing?
I'm doing well.
Good, alright. You managing all of it?
Just about, I
think. Alright. You don't want to swap?
No, I'm good here.
That's good to hear because I'm not going to leave this seat anyway. So from here, what we're going to do, we're going to sit on the seat, or I'm going to sit on the seat. Siobhan's going to just bend the hips down, so she's going to sit in her imaginary chair, and you're going to reach out and pump for 4, 3, 2, 1. We're both going to stand up. Remember just to push the weight up through the heels. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and then we're going to both go back down. 4, 3, 2, 1, back up. 4, 3, 2, 1, we're reaching across the body, all the way back down. 4, 3, 2, 1, we're coming up. We're going to punch up this time, we're going 4, 3, 2, 1, back down. Slow back to the seat, and then reach it up again. 4, 3, 2, 1, all the way up. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and back down slow. From there again, we'll go out in front, reaching across. 3, 2, and 1, slowly back up. 4, 3, 2, won't back down. If you feel you need to take an extended break on the chair, by all means do, and we're going to punch up again. So we're 4, 3, 2, and 1, all the way up. 4, 3, 2, 1, back down now. There's two more left, folks, now keep it going, and we're going to box down now to the ground. So 4, 3, 2, 1, back up, up high this time, reaching across. 4, 3, 2, and 1, and back down now. Last time now, we're going to go for 10. We're going to finish strong. So we're going to go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 2, 2, 2, keep it going, 2, stop and pause, and 1, well done. Great stuff, folks, okay? Shake out the arms, shake out the legs again. If you need to grab drink water, do so now. And we're going to finish now just with a small bit of a dance. We have someone, another international star, is going to be joining us this morning. So just welcome him in. As may know, hasn't been seen in a while. Apparently he's just taking a break. So I'll ask you just to point the toe on the ground. And what you're going to do, we're going to move the heel from side to side. So like so, you're going to twist the knee and back. So the knee's going over and back, and we're moving from the hip. Okay? And then we're going to pick up the pace then if we can. Just over and back. Alright, so that movement's coming from the hip. Slight bit of movement from the knee, but the knee is moving from side to side. Alright, we're going to change the other foot now. So heel off the ground. Twist the heel from side to side. Alright, just nice and easy to begin. And then if you're ready, you can pick up the pace, just over and back. Hands on the hips for the balance if you need. Alright. That's 3, 2, and 1. And then we're just going to reach in front, stay nice and tall. Just reach it out. Over and back, right and left. Nice and easy to begin. And now we're going to pick it up. That's it. So we have the elbows knee, we have the elbows swing. Good way to finish off the week with a bit of rock and roll. Alright, and then we're just going to tap the left feet. Just take a breather on that one. And I'll ask if you have a partner now, just get your partner facing. You can both stand, both sit, or vice versa. Okay, so we're just going to turn around. Nice and easy on the swing. And then, as the music picks up, we're going to pick up the pace as well. Here we go, get the hips in there as well, just ball from side to side. That's it. Great stuff, just swing it over and back. Nothing too hectic. Just get the arms moving. Nice and slow again to begin with. Just take it easy. And then if you're both happy to stand, you can stand up. Get the knees and getting the hips going, that's it. I was told I couldn't dance. I'm starting to believe them now. Just pop it over and back, right stop. And then we're going to slow it back down. And all the way down. And give yourselves a bow. You can bow to me. Well done, folks. Great stuff. Okay, again, just before we start our stretch, just grab a drink of water if you need. And we'll get a good stretch then before we finish. Alright, so let me know how you get on with your dancing partner at the end. If you're still speaking, or just about speaking, okay? You can try that one now over the week. Or over the weekend even. Okay, so we have a few people joining us in there. Great to have you, Martina from Cavan there. Great to have you, Martina. Okay, so we're going to finish now with our stretch. And again, you can choose to do these from a standing position or a seated position as well, okay? So the first one is, we're going to lift our shoulders again up towards the ceiling. So up just under our ears, and we're going to roll back. Up and roll back. And last time now up, and we're going to hold at the top, and we're going to roll back. And again, that's the posture we want to keep. We want to stay nice and tall but relaxed. Okay. So from there, we're going to take our chin, and we're just going to look over our right shoulder. And you should feel a little bit of a stretch or a strain here, okay. Shouldn't be painful. Just a nice stretch. We're going to go back to centre. Chin then over the left shoulder. And again, just hold that for a stretch. Back to centre again. And from there, we're just going to reach both our hands out in front. And just stretching the upper back. Alright, and from there then, we're going to get our hands away. Place them just at the base, or the back of our hips, the base of our back. We're going again, sitting up nice and tall, keeping that chin pointing forward. We're just going to take the elbows together. And we're going to hold it there. Alright, and from there then, I'm going to grab the outside of the leg. She wants to put her hand on the outside of her leg. And I'm just going to lean down to the right and hold that stretch. Come back up to centre and then down to the opposite side. And back up to centre again. And from there now, we're just going to straighten that leg, the right leg forced out in front. Slight bend and lean, now not completely locked out. Take both her hands. On the left side, stand up or sit up nice and tall and then lean forward. Again, keeping that chin pointing straight ahead. Back to centre, over to the left hand side now. Again, just pointing that toe away from you, hands on the thigh, sit nice and tall and just lean forward. And from there, we're just going to sit it back. Just to finish now again, we're going to close our eyes, put the hands to the centre of our chest, and we're going to inhale in through the nose, lifting our elbows as we do so. And exhale, elbows down, inhale. And last one, inhale. Keeping the eyes closed, just return your hands just to your laps. And just slowly, just take a minute for you. And when you're ready then, just slowly open the eyes. Shake at the fingers, the hands, the feet, the legs, and everything in between. Alright, if you have a partner, turn around, give them a high five. Well done, thanks to Siobhan for her help today. Again. She might get the seat next week or she might not. Depends if I'm tired or not. It does be a long wait. So thanks again, folks. A few comments coming in there. Pat, Willie, thanks for joining us. I don't know how that jiving is, Willie, now in terms of international standards, but it gets us moving anyway. Jerry Boxing's his favourite. Great stuff, Jerry. Kathleen, don't know what happened the last up. And we have Margaret there as well. So again, folks, great to have you all in here today and during the week as well, of course. So I'm just going to give the hands a quick wash. I'm going to ask Siobhan to do the same there. We're both just keep washing the hands. So we are back again on Monday as normal. Across Age&Opportunity now, we have different initiatives happening on Facebook and on YouTube and our website. And I just want to let you know about those. Tomorrow, Tom Meskill, our resident artist in Age&Opportunity, will be doing a few arts and crafts with everyday items around the house. So that'll be on here. The video will be on here tomorrow at 11 a.m. So tune into that if you're of the creative nature. And also, if you want to search for Bealtaine on Facebook, which is the Arts and Creativity Festival for older people during May, I'm sure Melissa or Anne will pop the link to that in the comments section below. You can check that out. There's numerous events happening between book clubs and photography clubs and various events. I know they have the Dawn Chorus as well, so they're great events there if you want to tune into those as well. Back with myself then on Monday at 11 a.m. I'm going to ask you next week, Monday and Wednesday, if you have a bucket of paint, small bucket of paint, that's a 2.5 litre tin there, with a handle, if you can grab one of those for next week. We're going to be using it on Monday and Wednesday as well for a few of our movements. I know there's a lot of DIY and everything going on around the place now, so I'm sure you have one of those popping about. I'd advise now that to use a full one, that one there, nearly empty, there's a small bit of weight in the bottom, or if you want to add maybe some bit of weight inside and just securely fasten the top, then we'll be using that next week. Or if you have a bucket about the house, ideally something the similar shape to this, just with a handle as well. Okay, so we're going to be using that next week. Ross Barrett, thank you Ross and John Portnew and Sarah Kennedy, you're very welcome Sarah. I'll pass on your thanks to Siobhan and Mary Cox as well. Lovely to see Siobhan. You're probably getting fed up with me now, Mary. I'm going to see Siobhan here on her own next week. So that's it, folks, for another week. Thanks again for tuning in and being here with us. It's great for us to be able to deliver these. I'm glad that everybody's getting benefit from them as well. I wish you a safe weekend, a nice weekend. Hopefully the weather keeps up as nice as it has been. And I'll see you back here again on Monday at 11 a.m. for our seated session. Stay well and stay active.